left her. I wonder what they were thinking. Yes, Jesus raised his Lazarus.
Yes,
Our daughter who had died of her on her deathbed. Mm-hmm. I wonder what they were thinking. Behold, there was a woman who was diseased with an issue of blood for 12 years, came behind him and touched his garment and was healed. I wonder what she was thinking. Jesus healed the two blind men that were sitting by the wayside when they heard that Jesus was passing by. I wonder what was they thinking. Jesus was on his way to Jerusalem. And he called his disciples to the side and told them how that he was going to be betrayed and be condemned to death. But on the third day, he shall rise again. I wonder what were they thinking. When Jesus is not found in the tomb, I wonder what were they thinking. When he was on his way up to Golgotha, I wonder what he was thinking. He was thinking of us.
Yes,
yes. Yes, yes.
Yes.
Yes. Thank you.
All right, here is concerning my dad. Last Tuesday, my dad is Alzheimer's. And and I noticed because my sister and my nephew take care of him, and he gets dehydrated real fast. And when I tension like that, his skin stayed up. And I know that it was dehydration, so I took him to the doctor, and I told the doctor I wanted him in the hospital because he wasn't responding. He was sitting up in the wheelchair, but he just wouldn't respond. Mm-hmm. And so the doctor, the first doctor he had, primarily, she gave him up, so she transferred him to another doctor, which we didn't even know about until we put him back in the hospital with him. And she never come. And so it was kicked into the side. And so this time here, the doctor was telling me, I'm listening at him, Mr. Thomas, you know, it's like the stage that he's in, and it seems like there's nothing else he can do. And I'm saying, you don't have the final thing. I told him I wanted him in the hospital to get some fluid in him. Uh-huh. And so they put him on the fifth floor. And so when I walked up to the floor and I seen collagen, and it didn't dawn on me, but the word just stuck out at me. Uh-huh. And so then my sister reminded me what that meant. Mm-hmm. And so now, praise God, he'll be coming home Monday.
Amen.
And the idea that they thought that it was all over and done. And he's strong. And he's responding. He recognized my nephew's voice. It's a certain way you have to talk to him because he's hard of hearing. And it's a certain way you have to talk to him. He got many different names. He's got BB. He's got Mr. Thomas, and he got Granddaddy, and he got some old names, and he'll respond to him.
Yeah.
He'll respond good. And the idea that the nurses was smiling when she was laughing on the phone last night when she got ready to, I ain't gonna tell you about it. When she got ready to try to take his blood pressure. And when he don't want to be bothered, he'll resist. He's real strong, and she's trying to pull his arm up and put it. And when he got really irritated, when he told her words, so she knows she could talk.
And you know there's a lot of life in there.
Whose report will you believe?
Will you
in the
believe?
Lord,
we believe in the word of the Lord. His report is
God.
Hallelujah.
God, we during the happy resurrection day. You know what? We've all been resurrected.
Amen.
We were all dead men and women.
Oh, yeah.
Amen.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. He got up, so we got up.
Amen.
Right? So go out and tell somebody next week that he's alive. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you. I love you so much.
Amen.
He's alive.
He's alive.